start.
All right. Angelica Popolano, founder of 5050 Skatepark.
This is 5050.
Ever since the Parks Department removed the ramps from the Benjamin Soto Skatepark in Midland Beach, Staten Island kids have been looking for a place to ride skateboards and BMX bikes. Well, now the first indoor facility has opened its doors. Lisa Calagrassi joins us with a great story here.
Well, good morning, Ken. The owners of 5050 Skate Park took an empty furniture store on Front Street in Stapleton and turned it into a kid's dream, a safe, supervised place where kids can ride, rain or shine.
Tell me this is who you are. They tell me I've got something.
At 16, my life was in a spiral. I had just been arrested for assaulting my father after witnessing him hitting my mother. My brother had died suddenly a few years earlier, and my sister was battling with drugs and my mom depression. I would stay out as long as I could, just to not be home, which often got me into more trouble. Randomly one day, my best friend Monica and I decided to buy BMX bikes. We needed a change. We found a new circle of friends and rode every single day from then on. That's how I met my partner, Ed Pollio. I was riding a popular BMX spot on Staten Island when similar friends introduced us. We went on one date and it felt like we knew each other for years. From then on, and we never let each other go after that. Ed had recently finished a 6-year-long project with the Parks Department. He and his friends petitioned to get a public outdoor skate park built in honor of their late friend, Marine Benjamin Soto, who passed away suddenly overseas in Japan. Parks was looking for staff to run the new park, and Ed introduced me to Chief Mary Kelly. After a few interviews, I began working at the park from 2007 until it closed in 2010. I continued working with Parks for 2 more years, doing everything from artwork for special events, playground associate in the summer, assisting with after-school programming. After graduating college in 2011, I saw a great need for an indoor skate park. I'd always loved working with children and felt that the best way to change our community is by helping our youth at that crucial age when life stresses shape the outcome of their future. We wanted to provide a safe environment so that children searching for a way out, like Ed and I were, could always have a place to go. I came up with the name 5050 Skate Park with a bit of the feminist in me. It's 50% Ed's and 50% my own. We combine Ed's talent for ramp building and organizing in my work experience to build an 8,000 square foot park that caters to people of all ages and extreme sports. Although it all happened quick for us, I wouldn't say that it came easy by any means. We invested 6 months just helping the one landlord willing to give us a chance. We helped him clean out his furniture store and later transformed it into the skate park. Then 3 months after we opened, we were hit by Hurricane Sandy. 4 feet of water flooded the entire park, ruining everything we just built. We had been broken into a few times, overcame large amounts of debt, and are currently fighting to keep our park in Stapleton. Hangar 38 is an old World War I, World War II airplane hangar, resting on National Parks property in Miller Field, Staten Island. The building hasn't been utilized in years, and we would love to transform it, similar to what we did with our existing location. We already welcome schools to hold art and gym classes. We do a summer camp, we host fundraisers, music events, art shows, auctions, community meetings, music videos, commercials, movies, birthday parties, we do everything. With the larger space, we can expand on everything that we do already. Our goal is to create a space where the entire family can interact together. Life always seems to knock you down when you're on the right path. You just have to keep pushing forward in order to make it through.